Dear friends, my name is Naushin Nizami, and in today's session we are going to discuss about welfare economics, what is its meanings and what are its famous theorems in detail. This topic is a part of chapter 7, and let us discuss that what welfare economics implies. So friends, welfare economics basically evaluates alternative economic states from the viewpoint of society's well-being. So it's a separate discipline which is aimed at evaluating, at examining how the different government policy and decision making affect the social welfare, and how good or how positively it contributes to the welfare, and what are the gaps. So welfare economics is once a discipline which aims at evaluating these outcomes. It provides a basis for judging achievements of markets and policymakers in allocating resources. So along the criterions of welfare economics, one can actually judge whether a particular policy has led to achievement of some core objectives. And it also helps in coming up with a decision that how resource allocation should be done. So how resource allocation needs to be undertaken in a manner that it leads to reduction of inequalities and improvement in social welfare. This we can get to know when we study welfare economics in detail. So as I said, that economic welfare can be measured using various criterions or what you know as indicators. And applied welfare economics, it means applications of welfare economics, generally use the notion of consumer surplus to measure consumer welfare. So as the entire discipline revolves around the well-being of people of the society, so it also uses this concept of consumer surplus, which basically implies that how much is the net gain of the consumers due to some policy action taken by the state or the local or central governments. So this notion is widely used in applied welfare economics. Let's now move to the fundamental theorems of welfare economics. So basically there are two fundamental theorems of welfare economics. First fundamental theorem says any competitive equilibrium leads to a Pareto efficient allocation of resources. Now what is Pareto efficiency? Pareto efficiency is basically a situation in which it is not possible to make anyone better off without making anyone else worse off. So basically the resources are allocated in such an efficient manner that if you try to change that allocation, either someone would become worse off or someone will become better off. But it's not that all are improving and none is deteriorating. So there is some section of the society who also loses. Now what the fundamental theorem says is that any competitive equilibrium leads to a Pareto efficient allocation of resources. What it implies in simple words is that perfect competitive market structure, whenever there is a market which is perfectly competitive and there is an equilibrium in that competitive market structure, then there would always be a Pareto efficient allocation of resources in such market. So if we are analyzing Pareto efficiency in perfectly competitive market structure, no matter from where we start, whatever is our point of start, we will reach a stage where there would be a Pareto efficient allocation of resources. So basically, a perfectly competitive market structure in a way guarantees that there would be Pareto efficient allocation of resources. The second fundamental theorem is also quite related, but it looks at the same relationship in a different manner. So the second welfare theorem says that any efficient allocation can be attained by a competitive equilibrium given the market mechanisms leading to redistribution. So it's saying that efficient allocation, any efficient allocation which has been achieved by a competitive equilibrium. So you can say this first part is quite similar to the first fundamental theorem. So any efficient allocation which has already been obtained by a perfectly competitive equilibrium is possible if that market has mechanisms of redistribution. So if the individuals in the market can exchange, or if the producers in the market can exchange and they can shift their current positions, then this efficient allocation is possible. So, and competitive equilibrium is also simultaneously possible. So basically both these fundamental theorems, first and second fundamental theorems, are hinting towards general equilibrium, which has been obtained in perfectly competitive market structure, and they reaffirm that efficient allocation, or you can say Pareto efficiency, can be obtained in perfectly competitive market equilibrium where there are mechanisms for redistribution. So these are the two very famous fundamental theorems of welfare economics. So friends, in the next session we are going to discuss about the criterions of welfare economics. Till then, all of you take care and have a great time. Thank you.